aluminum soldering, and aluminum brazing with weld strength. We have two rods and fluxes to choose from. Super Alloy 1, aluminum solder, has a very low temp. You will not warp the aluminum with this product. It has a bonding strength of 20,000 PSI. Just make sure your aluminum is clean before you dip your rod into the flux and paint the part to be soldered. Almost any propane, butane, MAP gas, acetylene, or oxyacetylene torch can be used. Even a heat gun will work with this rod. Notice we are not heating the flux directly. We are looking for the flux to turn brown. This is your temperature guide, as aluminum does not tell you when it's ready without using our flux. We want the base metal to turn the flux brown, not our torch. When we see the flux turn brown and bubbly, then we add our rod. And that's all there is to it. It really couldn't get any easier than this when working with Super Alloy 1 and aluminum. Super Alloy 1 works fantastic when filling holes. We're going to show you another technique. After fluxing the holes, we're going to heat the flux and rod very quickly. When the rod melts, pull the torch off the part. Remember, Super Alloy 1 melts at a very low temperature. It'll even melt with a lighter. We're going to deposit our rod, do a very quick feather across, and then we're done. Same with the next piece. Flux it. Turns brown, lay the rod in, you're done. Now take a look at that, it finishes beautifully. Now if you wanted to completely fill those holes, just add more rod. The same rod will join aluminum to other metals. You will not find this at your local welding supply. The Super Alloy 5, brazing rod at weld strength. The Super Alloy 5 works fantastic on a large mass of material like this aluminum drift boat. We're going to use a brazing technique with an oxyacetylene torch. We broadly heat it around the large hole and open cut before starting our brazing process. The bottom of this aluminum boat has worn very thin over time from scraping on rocks and gravel in rivers and streams. Just heat the end of the rod and dip the rod into the pewter flux. We paint the flux onto our parent aluminum using our torch. The flux turns into a liquid and acts as an absolute temperature guide and helps the rod adhere to the surface. Unlike Super Alloy 1, it's important to heat the rod and the base metal at the same time. Add flux every time you add the rod, as flux is essential in sealing all holes in our aluminum boat. Always keep your heat moving on thin aluminum, especially when using an oxyacetylene torch. This is the brazing rod and flux you need when working around and over top the rivets on these aluminum boats. The Super Alloy 5 can do what MIG, TIG, and arc welding cannot: dirty, oily aluminum. We did not pre-clean the part to show you how well the flux works to remove the contaminants. Use the torch to apply the flux. The flux turns watery. Heat your rod and parent metal, and you're done when the rod flows out. The flux is washing away years worth of dirt, oil, and contaminants on this old air conditioning unit. We do advise cleaning your aluminum before brazing. We just want to show you the worst case scenario. The Super Alloy 5 polishes just like the aluminum and has weld strength. Always heat your rod and the base metal at the same time. It helps the rod flow out much better. We butted these two aluminum plates together, flowing out the Super Alloy 5 rod and flux, and that's all there is to it. This is a broken cast aluminum shift lever off an old Johnson outboard motor. You can't buy these anywhere. Super Alloy 5 is the solution to many cast aluminum problems. The lever is actually stronger now than it ever was. You can customize cast aluminum intake manifolds or just repair cracks like on this Holly Street Dominator. Why scrap a good part? With Super Alloy 5, a grinder, and an oxyacetylene torch, you can save many aluminum parts that were headed for the scrapyard. You can also build up as much as you need with the Super Alloy 5. The bottom of this aluminum boat was dented by the trailer. This too is a simple fix with the right amount of heat. Now for the hard part, choosing between Super Alloy 1 and Super Alloy 5, or you could just get one of our combo kits and save on shipping. Make sure to watch more aluminum repair videos and don't forget to bookmark muggyweld.com.